us die. But it's always hard on life.
Amen.
And we can't give up and sit down and do nothing because it's raining on the outside.
Right, right.
Because as surely as we are here today, whether it's rain, whether the sun is shining, whether it's sleet or snow,
let
him be ready.
Let him be ready.
When the Lord comes. First, giving honor to our pastor, Dr. Shepherd, to the officers of this great church, and to all of my many Christian brothers and sisters in Christ.
Right.
It's a blessing to be here this morning. And I do count this a blessing. Because you see, I've been on this journey a long time.
Amen.
I didn't start yesterday. And you see, I promised the Lord. I promised the Lord that I would serve him until I die.
Amen.
And I consider this a service.
Amen.
To be able to say something, hopefully that someone will be able to live by and will enlighten their lives.
Amen.
When Sister Williams asked me some time ago, she said, well, we got one more time. I think I've kind of been around. I think this might be your time.
Well,
I wanted to say no, but I'm very careful about that. When I'm asked to do anything for the Lord, I do my best. So whatever I do or whatever I say this morning will be what I have to say for you all that the Lord has given me. Now, one other thing, I promise you, you won't be here all day. I've been told that if you stand up and say something, go ahead and say it and be through with it, because if you keep going more than 5, 10, 15 minutes, you're going to be repeating yourself. You're going to be saying something that's not true.
Well,
so listen carefully as I go through this, and let's try to get something to help our lives so that we will be ready when the Lord comes for us.
Amen.
Our technician asked, said, what is your topic? And what is your scripture? I said, I don't have one. I'm just all over the place. And we really knew that was pretty much it, but I thought quickly, and I thought about a few scriptures that I have written here. So I told him to say, be prepared.
Well,
so that's what we always need to do. The dedicated women here at Mount Moriah Missionary Baptist Church have penned as their title, Ladies in Faith Together, which says a lot. They have many hats to wear and many shoes to fill. The acronym for their title is LIFT, L-I-F-T, LIFT. In Psalms we find 121, 1 and 2, a very favorite scripture that say, I will lift up mine eyes unto the heavens, and it's coming to my help. My help coming from the Lord.
Yeah, yeah.
Then in John 3:14, it tells us that as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up. So that lets us know that that lift is a very good word, and we find it throughout the scriptures, in the Old and the New Testament. Jesus himself tells us in John 12 and 32 that if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. You see, we have a great name as well as a great responsibility. So let us be about our Father's business, preparing to meet him when he comes for us.
Yeah.
Here at this church, we have the women's ministry lift, and we have the mission society. I'm kind of like the Bible now. That's the wheat and the tares. They stay together. They all is just like. When we start kind of separated, we don't know one from the other. And they're all the same, so we just work together. The women's ministry, the missionary society, we all do the same work. God created the heaven and earth and started this gospel shift that we talk about and started it moving around over the earth, sailing across the sea of time. This ship left the port bound for the promised land, that new Jerusalem, that heaven is Zion. Many passengers have boarded that ship, and as it sails, many more will get on board. Yes, all of us here this morning will one day board that ship.
Well,
we don't know when,
yes,
we don't know where,
well,
and we don't know how,
well,
but it behooves us all to adhere to the scripture as Jesus speaks it in Matthew 25:13. Watch therefore, that you know neither the day or the hour wherein the Son of Man comes. Adam and his descendants were the first passengers. God wanted to know how the ship was progressing, so he came down and began to walk and talk with Eve. That conversation got so interesting